Hey, hello, and welcome to a new video of mine. My name is Heer Buddha, and if you are new to this channel, welcome, and I'm very happy that you clicked on this video. If you are not new on this channel, I'm so happy that you clicked again on this video. The main goal of my channel is to give you hair tips so you don't make the same mistakes as the many hairfiles on YouTube. So I made a video before how to bleach your hair at home, and I promised in one of my reaction videos that I will make a video how to go from blonde to dark again without getting green or faded color. So today's video is how to go from blonde to dark. But before we start, can I please ask you to subscribe to my channel, press that notification bell. You can follow me on Instagram and you can also follow me on TikTok. If you are subscribing to my channel, you will receive many, many, many hair tips and you will see many, many, many hair fails. I'm here to explain to you how to go from blonde to dark or from blonde to copper or red or violet or any other color. The more blonde you are, the less pigment you have in your hair. Especially if you bleached your hair before. Sometimes it's necessary to bleach your hair to put a toner, like it's pink or it's ash or whatever. But that's the different thing. Sometimes you go to blonde and you're sick of it. You want to go to dark again, or you don't like it, or I don't know what reason. But you cannot put a box dye on your blonde hair and expect to be the same color as the box dye. It's not possible because you have three main pigments. That's blue, yellow, and red. That are the three main pigments, and you have to mix that to get the right result. So if you are blonde and you put a brown on your color with a lot of blue inside, your hair can turn green. If you are blonde and you put red on top, it will be copper or a faded red. You cannot just put this color on top of it, and that's also something we have to do in the salon. But I will try to explain how to receive a darker color from this blonde basic. I will show it with some of the strings, so you know what I'm talking about. The main thing of going to dark, and I see many hair fails because the people don't have the time or they don't want to spend a lot of time on their hair. But if you want to go from blonde to dark, you have to take your time. Otherwise, it will be a fail. But it's the same thing with bleaching. You always have to take time. And sections. I see many comments like, sections, but that's just the thing. You have to apply it good to have a good result. It's always the same basics. The first year I started hairdressing at the age of 12. The first year, the only thing I did was sectioning. Sectioning for cutting, sectioning for perming, sectioning for I don't know what, until I was sick of it. It was like, can I do something else than sectioning? And the teacher was saying, it's so important. I will say, yada, 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 yada. I don't want to hear about it. I want to cut. But after all these years, I have to say my teacher was right. Sectioning is the most important thing in our profession. If you want to go from blonde to dark, you have to color it twice. The first color application is called prepigmentation, because there is no pigments inside your blonde hair anymore. It's an empty tube. And you have to apply again some pigments. A basic, if you want to color the walls, you also have to put a primer first and then coloring. It's the same thing. So if you want to put a darker color or a red color, you have to put a primer. Let's say a primer, but it's called prepigmentation. You put some pigments inside your hair to have a basic, to color on. If you do that, your hair will be shiny, your color will stay so long, and your color will be nice, the color that you want. It will be the color that you want. If you want a color with an 8, that's your main goal, an 8, then you will have to pre-pigmentate with a 9. You will have to pre-pigmentate always with one tone lighter than your main goal. You know, if you color your hair, you have from 1 to 10, or from 1 to 10, it's the same thing. So 1 black, 10 is the lightest blonde. Then you have 11, 12, that's bleached white without any pigments. It's possible that you are an 11 or a 12. So always color, pre-pigmentate with one tone lighter. So if you want to go to a 7, your first color application will be an 8. Every color has a certain character. Gold, ash, red, copper, mahogany, gold, copper, you name it. Every color, like in a box dye, it's like auburn. Every color has a character, or it's just a natural color. Mainly, every color has a character, and that's the most beautiful thing about a color that has a deeper character, a deeper shine on it. So every color needs his own pre-pigmentation. So for example, if you want to color your hair with a natural color, just a natural color, or with a gold, so you see the difference, you have to pre-pigmentate with a gold color. You have to put some gold inside, otherwise your natural color will be dull or maybe green. That's why you have to put some gold inside. If you put this first product on your hair, always maximum with 10 volumes. And I hear you say, I don't have 10 volumes, so I will use 20 volumes because I don't have it. It's a Sunday, every shop is closed. I hear it many times on YouTube. Be prepared. If you want to color on Sunday, buy the right product. Maximum 10 volumes. Apply it, very good. If you miss a spot, if it's patchy, do it again. If you have a patchy pre-pigmentation, you will have a patchy end result. Don't do it the second application. Don't color it if you know it's going to turn bad. Ask somebody for help. It's always difficult to do it by yourself, but you have to apply a good amount of product, fine sections, and you apply it for, you let it rest for 10 or 15 minutes. Rinse it off, shampoo one time, very gentle shampoo. Don't rub it in, don't. Gentle cleaning, dry it, completely dry, and then color it with the result, with the color that you want. A natural color or a gold color has to pre-pigmentate with a gold color, but one tone lighter. You want ash, you want red, or you want violet, or you want copper, intense copper, or you want a beige. Then you have to pre-pigmentate with a natural color. Another one. You want gold copper, natural copper, copper gold. It's different. Gold copper or copper gold, it's a little bit different. So it has more gold or copper, or it has more copper than gold. You have to pre-pigmentate with the same thing, but one tone lighter. A different thing is mahogany. Mahogany is a different thing. You will have to pre-pigmentate 3/4 of natural and 1/4 of red. Mix that together and then you can apply the mahogany. So these are the pre-pigmentations that you have to use to achieve your goal. If you don't do that, your result will be bad. I've seen it before, it's green or it's dull or it's like a faded color, like a color that has been applied for, I don't know, 1 month. If you want to have a nice result, pre-pigmentate. Maximum 10 volumes, one tone lighter. I explained it, maybe you can write down, maybe you can look at afterwards and you write it down. What do you need? I hope that you had something on this video. I hope you have a nice result. Let me know on Instagram below this video. Let me know if you did that and your result was good. I received so many comments or personal messages that some people had my tips and have a very good result. It makes me so happy that I helped you. So are you happy with this video? Please give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, press that notification bell. And all I'm going to say today, good luck and ciao kus.